No privately held company has ever launched humans into space before. At least, that's what we believed until May 30th, 2020, when SpaceX launched Crew Dragon, the company's first crewed spacecraft, into orbit. SpaceX has currently transported 4 astronauts to the International Space Station. Crew-2, which is the company's second routine mission since the US resumed crew space travel. Stay tuned until the end of the video to know why SpaceX is sending 4 astronauts to the International Space Station. And please, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Futurephile, to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. Crew-2 is the second crewed operational flight of a Crew Dragon spacecraft and its third overall crewed orbital flight. Crew-2 is the company's most experienced and diverse team to date. The team includes U.S. astronauts Shane Kimbrough and Megan MacArthur, along with Akihiko Hoshide of the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency and Thomas Pesquet of the European Space Agency. Although the team has flown to space before, they are particularly looking forward to riding in the futuristic and fully autonomous Crew Dragon. Thomas Pesquet of the European Space Agency says, "The way it's laid out, it's just fantastic. You know all the time what's going on." The 4 astronauts will share 4 days with Crew-1 crew before they return from their 6-month flight. Members of the Crew-1 are Mike Hopkins, Victor Glover, Shannon Walker, and Japan's Soichi Noguchi. Currently, an international crew of 7 astronauts is living at the ISS. In an ideal situation, the station will have 3 permanent residents, with the crew taking rotation to leave periodically. As the spaceship goes up, it can carry a total of 7 additional people, allowing the ISS to hold a maximum of 10 people at any given time. With 3 Russians on board, the station is set to become unusually crowded, accommodating 11 people. NASA's Crew-2 mission manager Ben Stahl says, "It's going to be a sleepover-style period of time, with 1 astronaut sleeping in each of the docked SpaceX capsules." However, this will not be a typical sleepover for the team. During their mission, the Crew-2 will be tasked with carrying out numerous scientific experiments. They intend to conduct around 100 experiments during their 6-month mission. These experiments are the core reason why NASA and SpaceX is sending astronauts to ISS. These experiments include acoustic levitation, a technique that uses ultrasonic waves to move and manipulate objects or liquids without touching them. The idea that something so intangible can move or manipulate objects can sound unbelievable, but it is a true phenomenon. Acoustic levitation balances gravity by using sound flowing through a fluid, typically a gas. The process relies on the properties of sound waves, especially intense sound waves. On Earth, this allows structures and materials to float unsupported in the air, while in space, it can hold objects steady so that they don't move or drift. Acoustic levitation has the potential to be a valuable tool for astronauts researching the microgravity of outer space. Though the technology would be useless in space because sound waves would have no means to travel across, it could be used on the International Space Station and other spacecraft. And it is for this purpose why this task has been listed on Crew-2's diary. It would reduce the hassle of handling small amounts of hazardous materials in a confined space and would allow astronauts to simulate Earth, outer space, and other conditions in a single laboratory. Furthermore, the ability of acoustic levitation to overcome gravity will enable researchers to simulate space-like conditions on Earth, eliminating the need for experiments to be sent into space. Another crucial element of the mission is the upgrade of the station's solar power system with new compact panels that roll open like a large yoga mat. The future of the International Space Station relies upon solar as renewable energy is set to ensure long-term power production for the once struggling operation. It wasn't long ago that the future of ISS was in jeopardy due to budget cuts and increased costs. Without a doubt, transitioning to solar power has been a game changer for the ISS. These new solar extensions and upgrades would ensure that the station has enough power to last until at least the end of the decade. The new solar arrays would increase overall energy production at the station by 30%, generating 215 kilowatts of power compared to the 160 kilowatts the current arrays provide. According to Josh Mohland, ISS Vice President and Program Manager for Boeing, "When it comes to game-changing research and technological development, the space station is currently hitting its full stride. These arrays, along with other recent upgrades to the station's power system and data transfer speed, will ensure that ISS remains an incubator and business model in the commercial space ecosystem for the coming decades. Access to this unique lab will continue to pay off as researchers study the challenges of future deep space exploration and make discoveries that improve life on Earth. From raising food in microgravity to understanding how our bodies change in microgravity, the International Space Station has performed research in ways that are not possible anywhere else. Talking about the body, one of the to-do experiments in Crew-2's diary includes a study into the effects of weightlessness on brain organoids. These brain organoids are mini brains created using stem cell technology. This experiment was singled out by the European Space Agency's Thomas Pesquet as his favorite. For as long as we can recall, researchers have been exploring how spaceflight affects human physiology and health. However, a recent study indicates that spaceflight could affect the human brain in odd and unusual ways, which could impair astronaut eyesight and last for a long time. From the days of the space shuttle program to the present moment, astronauts have reported vision problems after flying to space. Medical evaluations on Earth have revealed that astronauts' optic nerves swell and some experience retinal hemorrhage and other structural changes to their eyes. Scientists believe that these vision issues are caused by increased intracranial pressure or pressure in the head during spaceflight. In a recent study led by Dr. Larry Kramer, a radiologist at the University of Texas Health Science Center at Houston, researchers discovered evidence that this pressure does increase in microgravity. This, along with many other findings, backs up the theory that spaceflight increases head pressure, which experts believe is linked to astronaut vision problems. So, how does microgravity affect an astronaut's brain, and how does this differ between people? Scientists hope that this research will potentially help space agencies prepare for long-distance space flights that will subject crews to the rigors of space for an extended period of time, as well as aid in the battle against brain disease on Earth. Under NASA's Commercial Crew program, SpaceX has established itself as its favorite transportation provider. The Commercial Crew program was created to end NASA's reliance on Russia while also kicking off a new way of doing business at the agency. For the entirety of human spaceflight history, the government had been in charge of overseeing the design, production, and operation of spacecraft that carry humans into orbit. With the Commercial Crew, NASA wanted the private sector to get involved, and they did. The first crew test flight by SpaceX in May 2020 changed the course of history. SpaceX launched four astronauts toward orbit on April 23, 2021. Crew-2 was scheduled to launch on April 22 from NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, but it was delayed by a day due to weather concerns downrange of the launch site. Crew-2, the second crewed operational flight, is also notable for being the first to use a previously deployed booster and a previously used capsule, a primary cost-saving goal of NASA's partnerships with private industry. NASA's immediate goal is to be able to reuse booster rockets at least 5 times for human space flights, while SpaceX hopes to use its Crew Dragon spacecraft to master the art of human spaceflight. Crew-2 is scheduled to dock with the ISS about 24 hours after launch at around 5:10 a.m. Eastern Time on Saturday. The Crew-2 team will perform a full-duration mission on the IST and will have contributed significantly by the time they return. However, it cannot be denied that the mission also came at a time of increasing uncertainty about the future of the ISS, with Russia announcing that it is considering quitting the program and hoping to build its own space station by 2025. If you liked watching this video, you may also watch the video on Why NASA is Losing to SpaceX at Innovation, shown in the end screen. See you there!